Yeah, this is Yosepu, Assistant Professor of CS Department, St. Martin's Engineering College. So I would like to give presentation on divide and conquer. So it is one of the design technique to develop an algorithm or to write an algorithm. Okay, different methods are there to devise an algorithm. Okay, so first method is divide and conquer. Now let me explain now clearly. Okay. Before going to understand about this design method, I'll give a simple example. Now our India, let us take our India. So India is divided into various states, no? Why? What is the reason? What's the reason to divide our country into different states? Because our country is the largest. Okay. So it's a very big problem to rule the entire country at once. So that's why India is divided into various states. Ruling our country is a big problem, okay, because of population and because of area. But ruling our country is a big problem. So if the problem is complex, divide the problem into sub problems. So that's why India is divided into different states, okay, and each state is divided into districts. Each district is divided into mandals, okay. So this problem, when the problem is complex, divide the problem into sub problems. If the sub problem is still large, divide the sub problem into smaller problems. This process continues until a problem becomes very easy to find the answer. That is a very simple example to understand. Now let us take our college is St. Martin's Engineering College. Okay. Now first year strength is 900. Let us assume that. Okay. Let us assume that first year strength is 900. Now teaching first year students at a time is a complex problem. So that's why this problem is divided into sub-problems. Okay. 900 students categorized into different branches. For example, civil, second one is triple E, next mechanical, next ECE, next CSC, AML. Okay, A and ML. Next one is IT. Right? Now, okay, 900 students divided into various branches. Now, what is the strength of the EC? For example, 240. Now, strength of the CS is 240. Again, teaching 240 students at a time is difficult. Okay? Why it is difficult? Okay, it is unable to control all the students at a time. It is unable to monitor all the students at a time. So that's why again CSE students divided into four sections like A, B, C, D. Now each section contains 60 students. Okay. Now teaching 60 students is easy. Now what do you understand here? What is the problem size here? 900. This 900 are divided into various problems. How many problems? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. So there is a problem. What is the size of this input? 900. Okay. Now this single problem is divided into 7 sub-problems. So this problem, sub-problem is still large. Okay. Teaching 240 students is not easy. Again, that's why it is again divided into 4 sub-problems. A, B, C, D sections. Now it is very easy to teach these students. Now, what do you understand here? The problem is complex. Divide the problem into sub-problems. Okay. Divide the problem into sub-problems. So, if the sub-problem is still large, divide the sub-problem into smaller problems. So, this process continues until a problem becomes very easy to find the answer. Now, there is a general method of the divide and conquer. Okay, now what is the divide and conquer general method? So in this method, the problem is complex. If the problem is complex, divide the problem into sub-problems. So if the sub-problem is still large, divide the sub-problem into smaller problems. So this process continues until a smaller problem becomes very easy to find the answer. That is divide. So after that, combine the solutions of all the sub-problems to get the solution for the given problem. That is conquer. How conquer means combining. So combining the solutions of all the sub-problems all the sub problems to get the solution for the given problem. So that is a general method. So general method, right? Now I write the general method of the divide and conquer or control abstraction of the divide and conquer. Okay, see here, control abstraction. So algorithm, so D and C here P. Okay, next if small of P, so return of S of P, else. Okay, so apply, so D and C on P. Apply D and C on P. That means we are going to divide them. Right. Next, combine P1, P2 and so on, P. Next, here. So divide and conquer general method. So if the problem is complex, divide the problem into smaller problems or sub-problems. The sub-problem is still large, again the divide sub-problem into smaller problems until we could able to solve the problem. Okay. Later we have to combine the solutions of all the sub-problems to get the solution for the given problem. Now let us try to understand this one. Okay. Now there are three functions in this control abstraction. One is a small of P, the second one is S of P, third one is combine. Okay. So what do you mean by P here? Problem. Okay. Now come to the first line. If small of P, so it is a Boolean function. What is the use of this Boolean function? Which checks whether the problem is complex or not. If the problem is large, it returns false. If the problem is small, okay, it returns true. Let us assume that problem is large. Okay, it returns false. Let us assume that problem is small. For example, if the problem is small, it returns true. Now this function gets executed. Now what is S of P here? S of P means which returns the final solution of the given problem. That is one case. Now come to the second case. The problem is large. It returns false. So else block will execute. What is there in the else block? Apply divide and conquer. Okay. Or first divide the problem into case of problems. That is the actual point. 1 minute, I'll correct it. Okay. So divide P into K sub problems. Case of problems. Okay. So divide P into K sub problems. Now second one is apply divide and conquer method on P1, P2 and so on PK. Now let us take this P. So if the problem is large, what we are doing here? We are dividing this problem into K sub problems like P1, P2, P3 and so on PK. That is a step here. Divide P into K sub problems. Okay. Now apply divide and conquer method on P1, P2 and so on P3. Now that is a recursive manner. Okay. Now this P1 again divided into sub problems. Okay. And if it is large, again this P2 is divided into sub problems. So this process continues until a sub problem becomes very easy to find the answer. Okay. Now combine. What is the next one? Combine the solutions of all the sub problems to get the solution for the given problem. Okay. So this is a general method or control abstraction of the divide and conquer. Now what are the applications of the divide and conquer? What are the various applications? So we are using this method to write various algorithms of the various problems like binary search. Now I'll give the applications of the divide and conquer. Now where we are using this divide and conquer? At the beginning of this class, I told you, know, India, ruling our country is a big problem. So that's why India is divided into states. Again, ruling our states is a big problem. That's why a state is divided into districts. Okay, it is general method. Okay, similarly, in computer, computer fields also we are using divide and conquer. What are the applications of divide and conquer? First one is binary search. So binary search. Second one is match sort. Match sort. Third one, quick sort. Quick sort. Fourth one, Streisand's matrix multiplication. Streisand's matrix multiplications. Okay. Let us try to understand the four applications. So divide and conquer applications. So binary search, next match sort, next quick sort, next one is Streisand's matrix multiplications. So let's take binary search. So we know different types of searching techniques. Okay. So we have learned two types of searching techniques. So one is a linear search, second one is a binary search. So linear search is a sequential search. Okay. And its efficiency is poor compared to the binary search. Okay. So that is different topic. Now come to the binary search. Here in binary search method, the list of elements divided into two parts. Now let us take example. So 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. Okay. What is the size of this problem? 7, because this list consisting of 7 elements. Okay. Now what is the problem here? Search an element in the given list of elements. Of course, we have 7 elements. It is very easy to find the given element in this list. For example, 1 lakh elements are there. 1 lakh elements. Okay. Is it possible to search an element within 1 second? Manually? It is not possible. No? For example, 10 lakhs elements are there. 1 million elements are there. Is it possible to search an element in the among 10 lakhs elements? No, it is difficult. So that's why we are using searching techniques. Okay. So either linear search and binary search. Now our topic is binary search. So what's the problem here? Search an element in the given list of elements. Now if you use the binary search method, this method will divide the list of elements into two parts based on the middle element. How to find the middle element? So mid element. So position of the low element and position of the high element divided by 2. So I'll get middle element. Now what is a middle element here? This is a middle element. Okay. Simply we can say that there is a middle element. Now what do you understand? This list is divided into two parts. This list is divided into two parts. Now let us assume that our searching element is, I want to search an element 20. I want to search an element 20. Okay. Now what happened here? This problem is divided into two sub problems. This list is divided into two sub parts. Now there is a part 1 and this is part 2. There is a left part and this is right part. Problem 1 and this is problem 2. Now what is our aim? We need to search this element. What is that element? 20. Now 20 is compared with middle element. Okay. So here, and we know the 20 is less than the 40. So if 20 is the given element, if an element to be searched is less than the middle element, searching process continues in the left part. Right part will be skipped. Okay, right part will be skipped. Right? For example, I want to search an element 60. Now 60 is compared with? 60 is compared with the middle element, 40. So here searching an element is greater than the middle element. So searching process continues in the right side. Okay. Now come to this. Let us take 20 only. Now this element is less than the middle element. So searching process continues in the left part. Again, this list is divided into two parts based on the middle element. Okay, now there is a list. Now what is the middle element here? 20. 20 is equal to 20. Okay. So we got the output. Now in this way, by the search, use the divide and conquer. Thank you. Thank you very much.